So we lift you high, Yahweh. So we lift you high, Yahweh, and we lift you high, Yahweh, Yahweh, and we lift you high, Yahweh, and we lift you. You alone deserve my worship. You alone deserve my praise. You alone deserve the honor.
somebody and tell them, I need you.
I need you.
You need me.
You need me.
We're all apart.
We're all.
all clap your hands, everybody.
That is active, a love that is captive, to pursue in a heart that is passive. I can't explain the feeling of being loved by a love that is living and breathing, a love that never destroys, even after I throw out a cup full of toys, but a love that always enjoys, that it employs itself to come drown out all of the noise when I'm dim or beaming, boiling or steaming, when I'm happy or when I'm kicking and screaming, through sowing and reaping, when I'm growing and weeping, somehow your love is still mine for the keeping. And when I'm distant, when I'm not receiving, in that instant when I am not believing, I still can't explain this feeling of being loved by a love that is living and breathing.
Come, Holy Spirit. Among us, come Holy Spirit, pour some oil, flow living water, flow within us, flow living water. Your love is alive, it's breaking the dark. From the heart of stone, your love is alive. It's breaking the darkness, it's winning the fight, and bringing the orphan. Tando,
time. That neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. We brought nothing into the world, and we take nothing out. The Lord gives and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, but then shall I know even as I also am known. None of us lives to himself, and none of us dies to himself. If we live, we live to the Lord, and if we die, we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I am going there to prepare a place for you. We believe that Jesus died and rose again, and so it will be for those who died as Christians. God will bring them to life with Jesus. Thus we shall always be with the Lord. Comfort one another with these words. Would you bow your heads and let us pray? Heavenly Father, in your Son Jesus Christ, you have given us a true faith and a sure hope. Help us to live as those who believe in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to eternal life. And strengthen this faith and hope in us all the days of our life, through the love of your Son, Jesus Christ our Saviour. Amen. We welcome you to the service and we ask, could you please sit? Remind you, unfortunately, with COVID regulations, we need to keep our masks on. And we cannot have any congregational singing. These are indeed strange and confusing times. I'm going to ask Fikile to come and introduce the speakers from the family.
I'd like to greet Abaga Maqula, ngibingelele abaga Sibiya, abaga Bithelezi, ngibingelele the friends, the family at large, abaga Sihlobo. We are here to bid farewell to Phumla, Celiwe, Linda, ozalelwe ka Sibiya, ondeleka Maqula. Onigwe ikama makafika bathi she is Sinovuyo. She is bringing joy. With not taking too long, thank you, Pastor Reverend Ian. I'd like to call upon a speaker, a representative from the Sibiya family, Mam Buhle.
Ikabanaki, oh how ocean, Oki Ubo, Ninkalvari, Wamorena, Yahetanifu, La Sefa, Bano, Uriba.
Ngithanda ukubingelela wonke umndeni olapha kule ndlu yenkosi. Ngingumama uBuhle bakaSibiya. Ngimelele ubaba nomama bakaSibiya, umama bakaPhumla. Ngalokho ngithi igama lenkosi malibonge ngaphakathi kwendawo. Sibuhlungu kakhulu thina bakaSibiya nomndeni wakaMaqula ngokusivelele namhlanje. We never thought ukuthi today we'll be standing silapha sikhuluma ngomntwana wethu uPhumla. uPhumla esimbuke eingane ekhula kwaSibiya. uPhumla sambuka eingane efundayo isikole. Sambona uPhumla ekhuphuka iteshi ngeiteshi uPhumla wasebenza. uPhumla wathola umendo kwaMaqula. uPhumla waseba umama weingane zakhe. uPhumla ube yikho konke yithi sonke kwaSibiya nabakwaButhelezi nemindeni yonke nje ihlangene lapha kule ndlu namhlanje. So ke sithi siyaduduzeka ngokuthi namhlanje sibizwe inkosi. Inkosi ayibabizi abantu esuke ingangabadingi. Kodwa sekuyisikhathi sokuthi uzani kimi. Ngoba igama lasho lithi useduze kwalabo abayinhliziyo ezidabukileyo. uPhumla kumama kubaba wakhe ube yikho konke ngoba umama engasekho. Ubazi ubaba ukuthi uma ngabe ngithi kunje ngicela usizo kanje uPhumla would be there esiza umama wakhe. Together nomyeni wakhe uLwanga ngoba konke lokhu kwenzeka because of togetherness. Akekho umuntu ozenzela intando yakhe. So inhlonipho uPhumla akade enayo emndenini uhambe nayo uPhumla kwathi noma simganisa kwaMaqula sasineqholo lokuthi siyazi ukuthi akukho okuyosiphatha kabi ukuthi kube sekuthiwa nakho esingakuboni nakho esingakuboni. Ukwenze konke ekhaya simbona ukuthi uyoba ingane ukuthi nalapho eyakhona uyofika abe isibani esikhanyayo. Njengoba amukeleka kwaMaqula bamupha lelo gama leli namhlanje silazi ngayo ukuthi uSinovuyo. Kusho ukuthi nabo kwaba khona ukuthi sijabulile ngoba sithole indodakazi. Waba indodakazi yakwaMaqula. Nathi sathola indodana ngapha kwaSibiya konke lapho bekuhanjwa khona imisebenzi yonke besibabona bebonke lokho kusho khona ukuthi uthando lemndeni imndeni ihlangene ihlanganiswe uNkulunkulu kodwa ke singeke sikuphikise futhi sithemba nokuthi utheme sekhuluma nomdali wakhe uPhumla wabona naye ukuthi kufanele ukuthi ngoba kuye owambiza emhlabeni wamletha emhlabeni ngoba noJesu washo ukuthi ngasuka ekhaya ezulwini kubaba ngeza ezweni ngizophetha imisebenzi engabelwe yona usesebenzile uPhumla ezweni kwafika isikhathi lapho esethi nami sengikubuyela kumdali wakhe wami siyabonga ukuthi uPhumla usiyele ithombe esizozibuka abantwana lokho okuncane okusese sibhedlela siyazi ukuthi wonke umuntu noma angaba mncane kangakanani kodwa uhlangene nomdali uhlangene nomzali wakhe ngoba naye lapho ekhona kusho ukuthi uvumile ukuthi mama ngiyabona ukuthi uyakhahlazeka awungishiyi ngedwa ungishiya nabazali ngizokhula wamkhululake ngiyacabanga ukuthi ungabheki mina nginomdali ongilethela emhlabeni kubuhlungu kithi kodwa uma sikholelwa ekutheni okwakulelizwe kuyadlula kusele okwangali ngaphesheya siyaziduduza ukuthi njengoba thina sisele nathi sasele ngoba umdali usasilungisele yethu indawo iyasho incwadi ukuthi ozelwe ngowesifazane insuku zakhe zimfishane ziyashabalala njengethunzi kodwa ukuthi asazi ukuthi thina soshabalala nini uyasho umbhalo ukuthi ngiyazi ukuthi ngizokufa kodwa ngazi ukuthi ngizofanini nokuthi ngizofa kanjani nokuthi ngizofelaphi kodwa ukuthi angihlale ngilindile sibophele inkalo zethu ngokuthi sibe kulendlu kuyasho ukuthi uSinovuyo nayo ubeyilungiselela ubazi ukuthi ngelinye ilanga umdali uyombiza ubezilungiselela ukuthi nje mhla engibizile nami ngiphumele endlini yenkosi siyaduduzeka ngalesimo noma sinama mixed feelings kodwa ngoba siyazi ukuthi ukufa kubekiwe siyakhala siphinde sithi asingakhali njengabangazi ukuthi ukhona umdali wethu ngithi ukuthi kithi sonke bakaSibiya abafowabo udadewabo duduzekani ngiyazi ukuthi uPhumla bekuyilengane ebingena two face Phumla njalo uma uhlangana na whether umbone 2 months or 3 months ago ungakhulumi naye angeke aza kubuza ukuthi njani uyohlala esmayila nje mamncane uhlala esmayila nje njalo with a smile everything that she was accepting with a smile bese sithembele kuye nathi ukuthi ngoba siyamazi ukuthi uyashesha nakwenzeni izinto ukuthi nje makunalokhu siyazi ukuthi Phumla would be there Phumla would be just sesenza iprogram whatever event she was that type of a girl who would just go forward even if nanicabanga ukuthi hey this can we shelve this for tomorrow no now so that we get rid of it sazi ukuthi we are sorted with that silahlekelwe kakhulu silahlekelwe bakaMaqula uNkulunkulu wasihlanganisa usasihlanganisile namhlanje usaloku uyoloku ehamba nathi futhi akasilahlile sibhlungu njengenhliziyo enhlizweni zethu kodwa akukho esingakwenza ngoba naye uthe umesebona ukuthi ubiza umdali wakhe uphumla nathi sihlele ethembeni ukuthi hayi kuzoba ngcono hayi kuzoba ngcono njengokwabanye abantu kodwa washo ukuthi uNkulunkulu yena uneplan lakhe and iplan lakhe is always the best noma thina sizolibona ngenye indlela is always the best that we must just admit ukuthi thina fanele sisale siqine sibambelele emthandazweni sazi ukuthi akukho okwehlula umthandazo ngoba naye lapha ekhona ngiyazi ukuthi umthandazo ubekile ubele kwezibekela nathi simbekele emakhaya kunzima kakhulu ukuthi sisamukele kodwa lisima kodwa we have to ngoba sekuzokufika namhlanje uNkulunkulu siyazi ukuthi umqalisi wendaba umphelisi wendaba lithe maliphuma igama lokuthi akasekho kwababhlungu kodwa ngoba kune process that needs to be followed uyaqinisana uNkulunkulu uphamandla ukuthi let's follow the process ukuthi egcineni sazi ukuthi umuntu umzimba wakhe uphelelaphi konke nje uNkulunkulu uvela kushape kuzo zonke lezo inyembezi kodwa siyaphuma senze something siloku sikhala sisizisula inyembezi siqhubeke siphambili siyabonga ukuthi usigcinile ukuthi namhlanje size kufile ilanga leli sikwazi ukumphelezelela uphumla simndeni sidumele kakhulu sidumele ngoba bekuyingane esiyaziyo ukuthi iyasihlanganisa ngibhlungu nje ngoba ufather ngiyamhlonipha ushilo wathi there's no singing wathi there's no singing sizokhuluma nje esithanda ukukhuluma ngoba mina ngiyazazi ukuthi ngiyathanda ukuthi ube khona iculo engilibekayo kodwa ke ngihlonipha umthetho okhona manje Sibonge kakhulu ukuphumelela kwabo bonke abaphumelele kulomsebenzi namhlanje kulesikhathi esinzima salomkhuhlane okhona kodwa sonke sithema siphume ngoba lokhu ijazi lethu okumele ukuthi silembathe silembethe nje ngempela makadunyiswe uJesu Kristu
Siyabonga Mam Buhle. I'd like to call upon Mam in mother in love, as she would call her, mother in love, ka Sinovuyo, Mam Fundiswa Maqula.
Sinovuyo mntanam. Bendingazi uba the message you sent me on Friday the 18th of June thanking me for all that you've done in helping take care of Phumla and your husband reminding me how much you love me would be the last of such. Thank you for honoring me, for loving me as your mother. You came into my family formally in 2016. Khange usicalucalule. Khange usijongele phansi. Instead, ufike wasakha. Wasibumba, wasithanda, and most of all, wasihlonipha. Your role as my daughter-in-law, you served with distinction. You've impacted Okwangwesh in a very positive way, and for this, we will always be grateful. God truly blessed me so much by providing me with a daughter-in-law like you. Obindixabisile endithanda endihloniphile. Your passing leaves a huge void. Kodwa ke, despite the pain, I say it is well. It is well with our souls. Thank you for the beautiful grandchildren. We will raise Lumela and Sika in accordance with God's teachings, Sanala, which is the life you lived. Ubumi bakho bungumzekelo, Dana. Lwanga, Sanala. You may be entering uncharted territory. However, God is still God. Even in this painful moment, we will walk this journey together, Mdana, as we've always done. My heart aches seeing the pain in your eyes. I know, however, that our Redeemer lives and that the sun will shine again. Lastly, and probably most importantly, you don't have to be strong. Therapy, in addition to our faith, will help us, will help you get through this. I urge you to consider psychotherapy. To your friends, Sinovuyo and your friends, thank you for always stepping up, bantwana bam. Thank you for caring and supporting Lwanga during a life-altering experience of his life and probably the lowest moment in his life. You are truly one of a kind. To the Sibiya and Buthelezi families, Nangamso, for the rain of sunshine you gave us. The pain cuts so deep. Kodwa ke, as the song goes, kulungile ba. Nangamso Sinovuyo, for the beautiful memories. Amba uyo phumla sanala. Kuba ke ugqatso ulfizile. I will always love you.
An angel that connected intentionally and related, authentic. I don't know how she connected with everyone. She was part of the boys, Abagalwanga. She was still connected with people from Wits that we haven't seen in ages. And just speaking about the friend that she was, I'd like to call Nandi, her childhood friend, to come up.
Mm-hmm. imbala zigubabaza zitwinwe.
I greet you all in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Today, we say our last goodbyes to our dearest friend, who actually became a sister, Phumla. 23 years together. Today, I must let her physical being go, but I will hold on to her spirit and her love for me and for her family. It doesn't feel right to say goodbye so soon. She definitely left us too soon. It feels as if she was ripped away from me, from us. Even though she had achieved so much in her short life, I was looking forward to so many more adventures and a lifetime of friendship. Her presence and her energy in my life is going to be missed so deeply and so profoundly. It's difficult to express what she meant to me. She had a joy for life that she was always wanting to share. She had such commitment to be part of everyone's life, as was attested to at her memorial yesterday. Phumla touched so many lives. I pray for her families, both sides. Ubaba, Nomama, Usismili, Pindi, Andile, Sfiso, Unane Zanele, that she loved so much. O Uncle Whitey, Abolondiwe, all her nieces and nephews. I could go on. These people raised us. Thank you. I find comfort in a poem by Margaret Mead titled, Remember Me. To the living, I am gone. To the sorrowful, I will never return. To the angry, I was cheated. But to the happy, I am at peace. And to the faithful, I have never lived. I cannot be seen, but I can be heard. So as you stand upon a shore gazing at a beautiful sea, remember me. As you look in awe at a mighty forest and its grand majesty, remember me. As you look upon a flower and admire its simplicity, remember me. Remember me in your heart, your thoughts, your memories of the times we loved, the times we cried, the times we fought, the times we laughed. For if you always think of me, I will never be gone. This is how we'll keep Phumla's legacy alive, in the everyday, in the extraordinary, and in the simple smiles of Uhlumi and Unzika. We will find her. To my day one, as difficult as it is, you have gained your wings so sore, my friend, so.
Zimbala zigubabaza zitwinwe.
Unandi ushilo ningi ngizobiza uput Andile on behalf of the siblings. We all know the siblings because Uslobo loved her siblings so much. But Andile.
I would like to greet you all in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. I stand here in total disbelief. It is taking a lot for me to actually even speak to everyone. When I was praying this morning, I prayed for strength. So what you see in front of you is not what is going on inside. But with the spirit of my sister, who was such a responsible young woman, who was an example to many people that she lived with and shared her beautiful life with, I am aware that I must come and represent my siblings. And I'm also aware that I will not do justice with the few minutes that I have to tell you what kind of a relationship we had with our sister. But I will just summarize some of the things and share certain things, Jomopumla. But what I found as well was the memorial service yesterday, it was quite what's the word? It was ministering to our hearts, because a lot of people spoke so well in Phumla and her character and what she meant to them. And therefore, for me to come and repeat some of the things will not do anybody, you know, any justice. Therefore, I just want to read something from my sister, Umili. She could not be here today. She is here, but she could not come and obviously speak and ask me to represent her. So I just want to share what she said, or what she would like to say to her sister. She says that, Hambakahle mtakama, sisters, I will forever love you. You are my friend, confidant, our guardian angel, and my pillar of strength. I will forever be so proud of you, and I will continue to pray as you ask me on your last day on earth. It is well you were in this world, but not of this world. I have peace that you are now with our Heavenly Father. And that is for my sister, Umili. For myself, what I would like to do, for me, really, it's about giving thanks. That's what I decided to do. I have so many people to thank. I want to first start by talking about Phumla's friends and the role that they played in Phumla's life. As a family, we are deeply humbled by just the love that you guys shared. We are humbled by how you guys helped us to celebrate my sister's life. And, you know, it is very true when they say that if you want to see the true character of a person, you just have to look at their friends. And Phumla, you know, had sisters in Christ and brothers. And, you know, I can start and talk about names, but I'm not going to do that because like she had so many friends. And somehow, when I think about it, I know a lot of Phumla's friends, like by name, you know, which for me is amazing. But that's the type of a person that she was. You know, when she did something, she did wholeheartedly. And she was everybody's darling. I want to also speak about my father, and thank my father and my mother, who without them, obviously, Phumla would not have been born. And I want to say thank you to Ubaba and my mother. And I know Uguti, my father, is going through the most in terms of the pain. There's a statue, and this is something I saw yesterday. called emptiness. And this basically statue in Switzerland. It's a man who has a hole in the stomach area and the chest area. And that statue basically represents a grieving husband. And the hole in the chest area represents the emptiness and the void that the husband was feeling at the time because they had lost their wife. So I can only imagine what my father is feeling right now. And I only want to say, and I mean, Phumla loved Ubabake. She did everything she could in order to show that love. I can only say, Baba, we will do our best to try and fill that gap, as difficult as it's going to be, because I get to come to find an opportunity. But you know, we will do our best. Yesterday's Phumla's colleagues, they spoke very well of her. I want to, you know, also thank them, because we spend a lot of time at work, and when they spoke yesterday and they said all those things about Phumla, which also surprised me, I thought it would be fitting to also just give a word of thanks and say to them, for giving Phumla all the opportunities that you did at work, we are grateful, and for everything and everything that you said about Phumla and making sure that Phumla's work life was pleasant. We are also very grateful for that. Lwanga and the Maqula family, I am thankful to the Maqula family for accepting my sister and just making them part of their lives the way they did. Mam Fundi, you were Phumla's mom in every way, especially when our own mother passed away. And you filled that role for her, and she appreciated you. And I want you to know that. But Lwanga, you know, my sister, there's a photo on Instagram where my sister says, and she's got a photo of Lwanga. It says here, "I thank God when I think about you." And that's the type of a relationship that Lwanga and Phumla had. They had a wonderful marriage. They showed their lives, their love for each other publicly. And Phumla would make poor Lwanga to do the most strangest of things, like making TikTok videos and take pictures with him with poses that you think to yourself, oh, okay. But you look at these pictures now and you really think, you know what, at least we have those memories in our, we will keep those memories. Lwanga, you have become a brother to us. You will continue being our brother. We are here for you. We will support you in every way, as we have been doing this whole week. We thank you as well for being the person that you are, making sure that everything that we see now today came to fruition. You took lead even when you didn't have to. You didn't say, well, you know, because you love my sister so much. And for that reason, I appreciate you, that you gave my sister the happiest years of her life. And you guys were then blessed with two children. We will help you as well as a family to raise the children. Never ever feel that you are alone. I know you've got your family as well, but Tina, as your extended family, we are also here. And thank you very much for that. Lastly, I would like to just try and say to my siblings, Umilupindi, Sfiso, Sibusiso, let us try and keep Phumla's spirit. In other words, somehow I feel like Phumla has set the bar so high that we have to step up as well. Phumla was the type of a person who would bring the family together, you know. She would show love in so many ways and touch people's lives in such a positive way. Somehow I feel blessed to have been her brother. I will really, and I am going to miss my sister in ways that I cannot describe. But the only thing I can say is that Nkulunkulu yas. Ngiyabonga.
Nonsiga, Slavo used to call Uhlumu Mancwadi, so that's the Thakazelo that I know. Eh, Tata, Lwanga love, as she would call you.
Simosania siso saku dase.
I greet you all in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Yeah, this is not something I would have imagined doing. Just shy of 5 years into our marriage, with two beautiful, wonderful children that my beloved wife, Usino, blessed us with. But I'm somehow comforted in the fact of, because of who her character was, because of the way that she had accepted Jesus Christ as a Lord and Savior, and thus preparing her way for life everlasting. I'm comforted by the fact that the love of God never leaves us nor forsakes us. I'm comforted by the fact that neither death, nor life, nor things past or things to come separate us from the love of God. So even still, in as much as her life was testimony to how God loved her and shaped her, even in passing and her being asleep, she is still loved by God and loved by me as well. Thank you for allowing God's love to just pour through you. Without measure, without fear or favor. You know, I said yesterday that you didn't class people in your life. You know, you treated everyone with love and respect. And so far, with the signs that I've seen from Mushumi, I can attest that she is your daughter because she exhibits the same qualities. Baba, nabakwa Sibiya, sibonga indlela enimkhulise ngayo Phumla. Kuyabonakala ukuthi bekasuka kwikhaya elinothando. Kuyabonakala ukuthi nimfundise ngendlela. You know, she always relate the stories that, you know, it may not have been, you know, it may not have been the wealthiest home at times, in terms of monetary value, but she always spoke of the sacrifices that you made, Baba, for all your children, not just her. She always spoke of the way you led them and you would sacrifice without thinking twice. And She was assured of her identity because of the role that you played in her life and shaping her. She tried to honor you to the best of her ability. You know, when you came home on Tuesday, you shared the story of, you know, how she'd organized the trip for us to go to Cape Town, and most recently, Limpopo, I think it was April. That was her way of trying to say thank you and honoring you and giving you the flowers while you can still smell them. To the siblings, Skala Sonke Bafwet, Nabusis Bam, thank you for taking me in as your chosen family as well. I really feel like one of the siblings. And I'm confident, you know, with everything that's been shared in terms of memories and words, that this bond will continue, because that is what Phumla would have wanted, and that is what I still long for. To my family, thank you for standing with me as well during this most difficult time. Thank you for everything that you did for Usino while she was still alive. Swash, you know she loved you very much. And she said thank you for taking care of Shumela as well. And I thank you as well for that. Thank you, Magaz, for making sure that when you did go down to PE, Usino felt welcome. There was no questioning, you know, what her surname was or whether she's an outsider or not. She always felt welcome, Ekaya. And hence she would gladly go, you know, whenever we could. Dab sisters, you know, Mos. Yeah, I think you guys clicked from the first time you met each other. It was quite special to see that, to the point that even when you obtained your accolades and education, you saw it fitting to have a present to share in those memories with you. We'll miss having the birthday dinners together and the flowers and balloons and just, yeah, because that's just the way she was. She loved, I mean, we heard from many people yesterday, she loved to celebrate people's milestones. Not just the big things, the also what we'd consider small things as well. Yeah, she was an exclamation mark. You know, if she were to be considered some form of punctuation, you know, she always added that extra oomph. I loved her zest for life. I mean, I'm a fairly reserved person, I would think, laid back. That's just my family in general. But somehow she was just, yeah, able to bring that out in me, and she rubbed off on me so much that, you know, I too loved the celebrations, and I too started loving to smell the flowers along the journey, because she'd always remind me, you know, whenever I had plans, goals, I was always sort of quite focused or militant in getting to the end goal. But she tried to remind me that, you know, the journey is just as important. So smell the flowers while you walk along the way. To the family and friends, yeah, we'll miss the get-together braais, you know, the hangout sessions that we had. Yeah, we would talk about a whole array of topics. And she always made sure to check in with you guys, how are you doing? And I'm fine was not a good enough answer. She would probe and probe because she genuinely loved you guys. And she genuinely wanted what's best for you. I think in her unselfish nature, you know, Umama was relaying the story, I think it was told by a friend during this week, saying that if she had to bargain with God between her life and that of Nzika. She would gladly say, take me. That's the type of person she was. That's the type of mother she was. And I'd like to salute all the moms and women in here and watching at home or wherever you may be. Thank you for being pillars of strength in our lives. We thank you for the prayers, the sacrificial love, the love without ending. We thank you, Mama, for covering us in prayer, genuinely wanting what's best for us always. Going home was always a sanctuary. It was always a place of refuge. It was always a place Usino looked forward to coming to. There was never that relationship, my mother-in-law again. And I think that's testament to the type of home that you tried to build for us. Thank you, everyone, for your continued love and support and prayers. To my love, Lala Maqula, sithandwa sami, ndahlala ndikuthanda soze ndikulibale. Enkosi ngohamba nam kobomi esiphilayo. You are my chosen family, and I'll choose you again 100 times over. To borrow words from a song, your candle burned out long before your legend ever will. Thank you.
Njengengilosi ezulini siyazithopa.
Ngicela uSfiso,
bazofunda. Sina sithi uyi.
Eka sihlobo.
On the 29th of October 1988, the Sibiya family was blessed with the birth of their beautiful daughter, Phumla Sibiya, who was the sixth child of Piwe Sibiya and the late Tembi Sibiya. Phumla Sibiya and Lwanga Maqula got married on the 22nd of October 2016. When she was welcomed into the Maqula family, she was given the name of Unosiviwe, meaning we have joy, happiness in isiXhosa. Sinovuyo started her educational journey in Bedfordview Primary before proceeding to Assumption Convent, where she completed her high school in 2006. She was accepted at Wits University and obtained a BCom honors in accounting. Nosiviwe furthered her studies until she qualified as an accountant in 2013. At the time of her passing, she was the regional head of credit at FNB.
Phumla's full life was such a blessing to all who knew and loved her. She had a big heart for people, always showing kindness and love, forever smiling. To whoever she associated with, she was a loving wife, a doting mother, an affectionate sibling, aunt, family member, and friend. She held in her heart the best interests of the people who were part of her life. Sinovuyo touched many people's lives in such a way that life without her will never be the same. She will always be remembered for the positive impact she had in all our lives. Phumla is survived by her husband, Lwanga, Maqula, and their two children, Hlumela and Tsika, her father, Piwe Sibiya, her mother-in-law, Fundiswa, Maqula, her siblings, Mili, Khatebe, Pindile, Sfiso, Andile, Sibusiso, and Lebu Sibiya. Lalang Maqolo, Masibiya, Ndabagumkulu, Kumet, Sibiya ngenkomo, abafokoza nabibiya ngamahlahla. Phumla, Sinovuyo, Maqula, Maleta, Soluzembe, Jebelendle, Mentuka, Mboyi, Mangwati, Nangamso. You will be dearly missed by everyone who loved you, especially your family and friends. Thank you for being an unforgettable part of our lives.
Friend Ian, for the word. Thank you.
Readings from 1 Thessalonians 4.
Greetings to all in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. The first reading will be taken from 1 Thessalonians 4. Chapter 4, verses 13 to 18, and I'm reading from the NIV. Brothers and sisters, we do not want you to be informed about those who sleep in death, so that you do not grieve like the rest of mankind, who have no hope. For we believe that Jesus died and rose again, and so we believe that God will bring with Jesus those who have fallen asleep in him. According to the Lord's word, we tell you that we who are still alive, who are left in the coming of the Lord, will certainly not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself will come down from heaven with a loud command, with the voice of the archangel and with the trumpet call of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first. After that, we who are still alive and are left will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so we will be with the Lord forever. Therefore, encourage one another with these words. Hear the Lord of the word. Hear the word of the Lord.
Thank you, God. Can we have our second reading from Romans?
Greetings, ladies and gentlemen.
Greetings in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I'll be reading from Romans 8, verse 35 to 39. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall trouble or hardship or persecution or famine or nakedness or danger or sword? As it is written, for your sake we face death all day long. We are considered as sheep to be slaughtered. Know in all these things we are more than conquerors. Through him who loved us, for I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God, that is Jesus Christ our Lord. Thank you.
Thank you. Would you just bow your heads as you sit? Lord, as we say farewell and we turn to your word, let it live in our hearts and lives. Amen. Unfortunately, are limited in what we, in the time we have, and so I could speak on Phumla and the gospel for hours, but let me just draw your attention to a couple of things that we have in the scriptures. The first is, although we go through life and are separated, life is about separation. We're separated from the womb. We're separated from our parents when we go to school, and you go to university, and then you're separated from your friends, and you're separated from your family as you get married. Death is the final separation. And yet, the one thing that we never separated from is God and God's love. And Paul is absolutely clear on that. Nothing can separate us from the love of God. In the first reading, the Thessalonians were wondering about death. What about these people that had died? They were living soon after Jesus had lived, and they were expecting him to come back, and he hadn't come back, and suddenly people were dying, and they said, what happens now? We don't understand. This doesn't make sense. And Paul says, God will look after everyone. And today we're at a space where a lot of what we see and experience and are living through doesn't make sense. But we need to hang on to what God says, that we will be with the Lord forever. And that is our hope. The devil will tempt us to not believe it, as he always does. He always makes us question God's word. And I would say, hang on to God's word. Remember, nothing separates us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. And if we are held in God's love, and Phumla is held in God's love, we are remain united in God's love for eternity. Amen. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, by your mighty power you gave us life, and in your love you have given us new life in Christ Jesus. We entrust Phumla to your merciful keeping in the faith of Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who died and rose again to save us, and is now alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit in glory forever. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies and giver of all comfort, deal graciously with those who mourn, that casting all their care on you, they may know the consolation and strength of your love, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Grant us, Lord, the wisdom and grace to use aright the time that is left to us here on earth. Lead us to repent of our sins, both the evil we have done and the good we have not done, and strengthen us to follow in the steps of your Son, in the way that leads to the fullness of eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And so we pray together the prayer that Jesus taught us, and we pray it in whatever language is most comfortable for us. So as Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Now may God in his infinite love and mercy bring the whole church, living and departed in the Lord Jesus, to a joyful resurrection and the fulfillment of his kingdom. Amen. Hallelujah. Can you ask the pallbearers to come forward, and will the congregation please stand?
Lord, rest in. lift you high to your will.
This is Queen
alone deserve my